A lot of times what I do is I actually try and sneak myself into different, my name and or like my photos or some of my family members. So if you've ever seen Deja Vu with Denzel Washington, it's a Tony Scott movie. We were doing a scene where it was like a face recognition screen. I took a picture of myself. So when they were like, they find the bad guy, which is Jim Caviezel, they start to scan his face. They put into like a directory, a computer directory. So I knew that it was the first one that's gonna show up. So I decided to put my face in there. So like, it's like forming my face. And then now it's there.
Right now, I'm with my friend Paul Luna, and he's a very super talented artist, and they have so much to offer. And one of the reasons that I'm doing these vlogs is so I can highlight artists. I want to expose something that my friends, because he's my friend, that has to offer, to the world. And even though he still has his regular job and he's super talented, a complete artist, and and I want to take the time to, talk to him a little bit so you guys can get to know him also, and show you what he has worked on, and maybe continue to work on, or what's in the future for him, or whatnot. But let's dig into it.
So my name is Paul Luna. I am the creative director for Universal Pictures for motion graphics, and I've been here for about 16-ish years. Before that, I actually worked on the movies, and movies like Minority Report, Star Trek, Mission Impossible 3. Once I was kind of, after about 8 years of doing that, working on the sets, long hours, I decided I wanted to get into something that was a little bit more of a set schedule. And so I started getting into the marketing. And so I was lucky enough to get hired by Universal Pictures. And so I do all of the trailers, all the TV spots, any of the Instagram things that all promote any type of movies, starting from Jurassic Park, Fast and the Furious, Despicable Me's, anything that's Universal. You've seen my stuff. You don't know that you've seen it, but I'm pretty sure that you've seen my stuff.
I was at one point working here also. Paul was kind enough to, help me get in here. And I learned so much. He hired me as a graphics coordinator? Graphics coordinator. And let me just tell you that I did, a lot of work with him for this company. And I learned so much, so much that after I was not working here any longer, I went and did my own visual effects for my own stuff, and one of them was my film Rewind, and because of him I was able to move forward and as an artist also, and this is why I feel like I owe him so much. And it's for me to make this video, it's also a way to give thanks to him, to if he helped me in the past, I'm gonna help him now too, Paul wrote this cool little book, and there's so much emotion to this little tiny cool little book.
At one point, I was waiting for my friend. We were gonna go out that night, and I looked up into the sky, and there was absolutely no stars. And then, the way my creative mind sort of works, I sometimes put stories behind it. So I thought, what if somebody was stealing all the stars from the sky? And so this. Now it's called My Pretty Little Star. At the time, I didn't know what the name of the title was gonna be, but it kind of resonated in my head for quite some time. And then when the pandemics came around, there was a lot of time, which we all know about, that the story stuck. And I talked to my daughter about it, and she really liked the idea, and it sort of blossomed into maybe I should make it into a children's book, and or like a small animated film. But I got to start a little bit small. So then I started coming up with some ideas, and then My Pretty Little Star sort of came into fruition.
What responses have you gotten from the book?
I got some very positive responses. It's very heartfelt, which was a little bit pleasing to me, because when I write a story, and a lot of the old cartoons, they never really were supposed to be for kids. Originally, they were just like little shorts that were made for adults. So there's a lot of humor that's there for adults that you don't fully understand, especially me when I was a kid watching those, that it kind of resonated and then stuck around for many years. Like the Looney Tunes is the one, are the ones that I'm referring to. So it's the same idea where I'm still writing for children, however, for kids. However, I'm trying to figure, but I also want the adults to be entertained as well. And so there's a little bit of a meaning in there, and which as a kid, you're gonna read it now, but then as they get older and in a few years time, they're gonna reread it and hopefully maybe read it to their kids. They're gonna actually make connections of, you know, some of the dark times where we have to be the light so that people will continue, you know, being kind to each other in this world.
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a link underneath to where you can get the books, whatever links you have active. I'll go ahead and put them down below. So please support him, you know, by buying the book. It's important for us to, you know, support each other, support other artists, and support, you know, our friend Paul. So what do you have? Paperback, and in Spanish, correct?
Yeah, so I have the paperback, then there's the hardcover in English, and then I just created a, the electronic version? What do they call it?
A book?
Oh, yeah, an e-book.
E-book.
All right, so I have a...
Is there an audiobook too?
No, there's no audio. Okay. Unless you read it out loud to yourself, the audio.
Is there going to be an audiobook soon?
No. And so then I decided, oh, I'm going to do a Spanish version, which this was the Spanish version. And ironically, I'm fourth generation Hispanic, so I don't really... My Spanish is not very good. I only know, like, the basics, like dos Jackie Cokes, por favor. Things like that, the important stuff. But anyways, you know, I know a lot of family members that only know Spanish, and so I thought this was, so I wanted to create this book so that others would be able to read this.
That's really creative.
Yeah.
Look at that.
So if you turn it around, that's what the Exorcist part looks like.
Dude, this is like one of a kind of of something to own that is just like, yeah. You don't even want to drink from it break it.
Yeah. I normally wouldn't. However, then I was like, I want tea. And then, oh crap. You know, well, I'm just going to open this one. And then my Invisible Man, I had two and somebody stole that one.
So the Invisible Cup?
It does the same.
And you drink from it?
I
but it's invisible?
It's invisible. So we had an Oscar toast, and they brought the Oscar, you know, for Oppenheimer and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so they had a 360 camera, and so, and I can send you the video.
Yeah, send me the video. Yeah.
Because it is kind of funny.
That's cool, and you look like super young too. What is it, like a filter? Or
no.
That smile.
Don't I look young?
Yeah.
They even gave us gloves. So that we technically wouldn't touch it.
Those are the actual...
Those are actual gloves.
No.
And so I didn't think about it. So when I'm spinning around, I decided to kiss the Oscar. And then, you know, it was like, oops.
You're not supposed to kiss it. Well, you did. It's kind of
but
like
I didn't know. Like when I was not creative director here, I would come on at lunchtime and then sneak into all the different stages.
Yeah.
And I always had like a little hard drive, a thumb drive on me. And if they would say, hey, you're not supposed to be here, and I would always say, oh, I'm looking for Monty, the video
playback guy. I have a hard drive for him. And then they're like, oh, maybe try back there. And so yeah, I would never get caught and stuff like that. But I would tell the guys over here, and then one of the interns, he tried to do the same. He tried to do the same thing, but not successfully, and he got kicked out.
So I think this is about it as far as you know, our conversations with Paul Luna, and this is great, you know, because it means that we are, or I am, and he is, you know, we are giving this to the world, you know, like just content for people to, first of all, relate, second of all, absorb some information, you know, some artistic information, and then pass the word. I think you know, forwarding not necessarily the video itself, you know, but forwarding the book, you know, My Little Star, correct?
My Pretty Little Star,
you know. Forward to somebody, give it as a gift to your niece, to your nephew, to a kid, you know. I think it's for us to keep the children in mind, because they are the future, and, you know, our next generation is the most important part of why we do things. You know, we want the next generation to bloom and to be colorful and to, you know, to be grounded and to be good, you know? So do you want to add something to that?
One little fun fact about My Pretty Little Star is the reason why it's called that is my mom used to call my daughter, well, she still does, but my daughter when she was younger, My Pretty Little Star. And so it's kind of ironic that it's kind of came a little bit full circle, because when I was trying to figure out what I can call it, I still wanted to kind of, you know, give a little bit of a nod to my mom and to my daughter, and so My Pretty Little Star kind of came together, and then actually helped combine the whole entire story, ironically. But you'll have to read it in order to figure out why it's all connected.
Cool. Well, thanks for being a part of this.
Oh, thanks for talking to me. I really appreciate that.
Okay, and it has worked for the people, for anyone who's watching?
No. Go see, you know, all my Universal movies that I've been working on. I'd appreciate it if you purchase the book, or if you know somebody that might be interested in something like that, feel free to purchase it. We'll put the link in the bottom. The ebook is very accessible, you know, so you can check it out, you know, for a minimal cost, and then, you know, it'll all help out.
Perfect. Don't forget to like and subscribe, everyone. Have a great day. Whatever you're doing, have fun, be safe, and much love.
There's a little like hidden gem in there when the graphic pops up for like two frames when illumination is going to light up. It doesn't fully light up right away, but there the L, the U, the N, and the A are highlighted. My last name's Luna, and so like for like two frames you can see Luna and before it lights up to illumination.
See the girl with the diamonds and the shoes. She walks around like she's got nothing to lose. Just see the go-getter, she's everybody's type. She's a queen of the city, but she don't believe the hype. She's got her own elevation, holy motivation. So I wrote some letters on big bold signs. I got faith in you, baby. I got faith.